In this video, I am going to explain myofascial connection from lower extremity to core. I am going to explain two ways of fascial connection. First thing is, this is gluteus medius, this is latissimus dorsi. There is fascial connection between gluteus maximus and latissimus dorsi. Let's say this is right side of gluteus maximus. Check the direction of gluteus maximus. Its fiber runs like this, right? It's going like this way. Plus, this is left side, latissimus dorsi. Its fiber runs like this. So, right side gluteus maximus and left side latissimus dorsi kind of match like this. Direction matches, right? So there is myofascial connection to opposite side of latissimus dorsi. Vice versa. This is left side gluteus maximus. This is right side latissimus dorsi. Their fiber is like this. So this connection is like contralateral. Contralateral means opposite side. Right side and left side. This is opposite side, right? That's why this is contralateral. Left side gluteus maximus and right side latissimus dorsi. Contralateral. So when right side of gluteus maximus gets tight, maybe left side of latissimus dorsi can get tight because of myofascial connection. You can say same thing for left side gluteus maximus and right side latissimus dorsi. Key structure is this area. There is white area in low back. This tissue is thoracolumbar fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia. This is very broad fascia on low back. So when this fascia gets tight, maybe it can affect both gluteus maximus and latissimus dorsi. When thoracolumbar fascia gets tight, it could create low back pain. Maybe that's why when gluteus maximus gets tight, people can get low back pain. This is very, very interesting. Thoracolumbar fascia is very important. So let me move to next connection. Next thing I'm going to talk about is this connection. This is hamstrings. And this is erector spinae. Erector spinae. Okay, hamstrings, and erector spinae. And I want you to focus on one more structure, which is this one. This is sacrotuberous ligament. Sacrotuberous ligament. This ligament connects sacrum and ischial tuberosity. That's why this is sacrotuberous ligament. Okay? Hamstring. Hamstring originates from ischial tuberosity. There is myofascial connection through sacrotuberous ligaments to erector spinae. So when hamstrings get tight, that can create tight low back because of this myofascial connection. Vice versa, when erector spinae gets tight, that can lead to tight hamstrings because of myofascial connection. But wait a minute, back muscle is not only erector spinae. There is deep core muscle such as multifidus. Multifidus. It is very deep back muscle. You can say same thing for multifidus. Hamstrings, sacrotuberous ligament, and it can reach to multifidus because of this connection. I just explained erector spinae as example, but you can use this kind of logic for hamstrings, sacral tibialis ligament, to multifidus. This is just different layer. Erector spinae is slightly superficial layer. Multifidus is very deep layer. So you can apply this theory for your clinical experience or training. You know, body is very complicated and mysterious thing. So there's no obvious answer for low back pain or tightness of human body. I just wanted to give you new idea to look human body. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.